And for 3 years, he was not allowed to meet any of his friends or relatives, nor his parents. And for 5 months there, he was just handcuffed, and his legs were bound, and he was not able to move. Okay. And it was only after when they were sentenced that they had to stay in prison for 3 years, that their handcuffs and foot were taken off. It was only after 5.5 months. So until then, they were all bound.
The Chinese government says that there's no torture in prison, and they say that there's religious freedom in Tibet. What would you like to say to the Chinese?
And per rawa ka che che rawa yus kena khanda samse dus
na ta nge sa na che sa gurta to go che sa zambal da duja che me se mo zo chando le na ta che sa zamba ma ji dun chen ta ta che sa da wa din se
ke he saying this is not exactly really true. He's saying the Chinese are giving a false statement. This is they're giving false statement. He's saying, for example, in Chamdo itself, when he was a prisoner, he's saying one prisoner was beaten to death. You know, so that's not, you know, true or prisoners, right?
What was his name? Do you know?
The Chonge Ming His name was Jayantile.
How old was he?
Lo khazar mi Chonge de.
Lo nish tajit.
He's about 28 years old.
And was it the same political reason that he put up posters?
Tandam Jayantile peke chonga na juga gimza khare kono kya ko.
Ah, ranzi yege jante.
Same thing. He put up posters and all this. Oh,
jayama. Okay. Tege chonga rama thola ta.
He's saying that in order to get a true picture of what Tibet is like and how Tibet is suffering in under the Chinese oppression, is that one should go there and see what's going on exactly. He's saying that the Chinese they proclaim that there is freedom of speech, there's freedom of religion, and there's freedom of civil rights, but as a matter of fact, nothing exists in terms of, like, say, for religion. You know, you cannot practice religion, and people cannot join a monastery unless you're 18 years old, and that also you have to make appeals to the government, and they will say either you can go to the monastery or you cannot go to the monastery, and you cannot speak your mind out. You know, you cannot talk freely as one would do in a free country.
Tanyin lodon dog na lodon do sa ka ta ko ka me tlek re ten san ta ye gen ob de sa de ta te che te te me.
He's saying that when he was in the monastery, he was not able to pursue his religious studies as he would have liked because of various restrictions put on the monastery. And secondly, there was no educational system as such in his area, and he was not able to go to a normal school, and he came to India because to get the blessings of His Holiness, and he wants to get an education here. Yeah, he's saying it's very sad. It was very sad for him to leave his country, because he's saying that, okay, it is his country, but he's been forced to leave, you know, and for various reasons, because there's no political, there's no religious freedom, there's no freedom of speech, and there's no educational facilities for one to pursue. And secondly, he's saying that because His Holiness is not there, and all the high lamas and all the high reincarnates are now living in India, and he's saying that that's another reason for him to come to India to get their blessings. He's saying that the tortures the tortures itself in prison were just horrifying, and the experience that he has had in prison was just unbearable. He's saying they would beat him, they would tie him up, and he's chained all the time, and hung up on the poles, you know, and beaten to such an extent that he would lose loses consciousness, and when he got up, he would be in a pool of blood, and with increments, and you know, everything, you know. So it's very, very sad thing.
And how is it once you leave prison? Does it stay with you, or do sometimes you think you're there? How does that work?
다만 그냥 중간에 쭉 튀는 사람 왔다. 그래서 점점으로 이제 그냥 섬으로 가다 중간에 딕 찍레기도 해야 돼. 섬으로 이제.
뜨든 뜨든 오늘 따 만나는 따 중간 따야 만들린다. 따 떠든다 만들린다.
He's saying yeah, it does come back. You get flashbacks all the time. He's saying during the night, you're sleeping and you wake up with nightmares of being beaten.
단다 구성.
아니 로카도 정말로.
따 다소 진짜 이해는 하고.
He's saying that in terms of you say. The Chinese claim that there's religious freedom, but he's saying as a monk he can clearly state that there is no political freedom as such, because you cannot have in your possession the pictures of the Dalai Lama nor the Panchen Lama, the Panchen Chogyi Genzen, the prisoner, the youngest political prisoner who is in China right now. You cannot have his picture. And the number of textbooks or the number of religious books that you have, if you are caught with them, that also you're liable to be punished. And he's saying sometimes you may get punishments of from 10 to 20 years. And he's just given an example saying that of one of his. Can I anirwe?
Anirwe.
Anirwe.
Mara aja.
Can I aja?
Aja tomo.
Aja tomo. Anirwe.
Anirwe.
Okay. He's saying his elder sister's friend, she's a nun. And she was caught with the picture of the
Kyamrum
Jukuba Simbre. Okay. And she had a picture of His Holiness the Dalai Lama, and she was caught. And he says he doesn't know where she's now. She's been caught but doesn't know which prison or where she's been put. He's saying he would like to thank all the people who have been supporting the Tibetan cause and would urge them to still support the cause, because it is a true cause. And he's saying that if people would like to visit Tibet, they should visit Tibet with an open eye, and they should not only be visiting Lhasa and the beautiful cities that the Chinese have fabricated, but rather should go to the villages, because that is where you see the true face of Tibet.
As year goes by, we found that nowadays these refugees are telling us that they are not seeing any Chinese soldiers on the way. So we feel that Chinese government, they are just allowing the Tibetans to go out of Tibet as many as possible. And they try to settle the Chinese from the mainland China to Tibet, you know. So these days, they are not stopping the refugees, you know. They're just coming freely, you know. So we found that there's some change of policies.
And there are also many Tibetans who are too old to go to a regular school, so in which case they are sent to the transfer school, where they are given a crash course in English, Tibetan, all other subjects.
Okay, here we go. I see, and then we have students who are taking a break. They're all in classes.
Tin roof.
There's about 30 to 40 people living there.
Steam bread. Very good.
Even then, I mean, you can't help but, you know, admire their courage, because to, as I've said before, it's taking your, you know, this life in your own hands. To escape means it's a sort of darkness, it's uncertain. You wouldn't, I mean, the person who decides to escape, he's making a decision where he doesn't know where the journey will, you know, end or how it will end, whether he'll be alive at the end of the journey.
Nasani nima chuksum moda na chim moda la phela tumbu ara tumbu jig na la mi tinju tendu ti ara mi tinju tendu ti jani nima chuksum kisala ti an jami ki masim
nima chuk nima khaz
nima chuksum chim bare moda
chuksum okay
she saying ga san sam le jesi ma
mi khaz ara
mi tinju tendu ya
so she's saying that they were all cramped, about 76 people were there, they were all cramped in a sort of a tractor trolley kind of thing, and so they traveled for 13 days in that cramped condition, and then they were on the 13th day they were caught by the Chinese police. Ani mommy simche
ni simni ma naju yara naju tenji la
during that 1 month period, she's saying that they were barely given anything to eat, and whatever possession or whatever money they had, they were all confiscated by the Chinese. And And during that period, she's saying that they were beaten various different ways. And she's saying that they used to make them hold hot water in their hands and keep on standing. And if they were not able to do that, they would be beaten by iron rods, you know, which were heated up in fire. And they were beaten on their hands.
Chadde mar chindi gala kena pumga pumu lu ni kha changa yin chhi na ta samche na ta shakchi cha
bu. And he's saying that as a physician, as a practicing physician in Tibet, he has seen many sterilizations, you know, and he's saying that women are above 25 were sterilized, and he's saying that is a very very devastating thing, and he wants people to make more strong appeals to the Chinese that they do not do forced sterilization and abortions.
Other refugees are, most of them are monks and nuns. And in the old days, we used to have many monastic universities where the monks can study Buddhism for a number of years, and they have a degree, doctor of philosophy like Geshe, and then after finishing that, they meditate in the camp, and the spiritual development, you know, so many facilities are there. But now Chinese have destroyed everything, and now even these days they have some monasteries there, but there's only for tourists to, as a showpiece, you know, to tell, to deceive the world, you know, that Tibetans are getting freedom of religion.
Being a refugee, it's not nice. And from my own, personal perspective, there's some degree of, you know, shame attached to being a refugee, because being a refugee would indicate that you were not strong enough to defend your country, or you didn't have the skill to defend your country when, you know, the Chinese invaded Tibet.
So she informed her desire and the intentions to her parents that she wanted to study and go to India. So her parents found somebody else to take her